गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू दिनेश मिंगलानी ट्यूटोरियल्स। इस फर्स्ट प्रैक्टिस सेशन ऑन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एवरेज। इन दिस आई डिस्कस अराउंड 20 टू 25 क्वेश्चंस ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ एवरेज। फॉर मोर वीडियोस यू मे लॉग इन टू माय वेबसाइट www.dineshmiglani.com, माय फेसबुक पेज दिनेश मिंगलानी ट्यूटोरियल्स, वेयर यू फाइंड लिंक्स टू ऑल द वीडियोस, माई व्हाट्सएप नंबर 09215154354 फॉर एनी क्वारी। You may send email to me at my email ID legalbuddy@gmail.com. For regular updates of my videos, you may subscribe my YouTube channel @DineshMiglani Tutorials. I expect from you to share my videos on your Facebook wall as well as with your friends so that more and more people are connected with this and they will be benefited by this activity. Let us start with solving the questions on the concept of average, right? Let us take it one by one. Earlier I told you that for answering the question, you have to simply make the equations and you can easily answer your problems, right? Let us take it one by one. Average age of students in a class is 21. If teacher's age is also included, average age goes up by 2 years, means it becomes 23. Find the number of students in the class if age of the teacher was 47 years old, right? Let us say number of students are X, so total age was 21X, that you can say. Teacher is included, total age of the class becomes 21x plus 47. Now my number of persons in the class are x plus 1, right? And average age increases by 2, it means average age is 23. So if I multiply my average age with number of students, that's my total age and that is also my total age, right? I have to find the value of x, that's my question simply. So what you can say, 21x plus 47 equal to 23x plus 23, right? That is 2x, right? And it goes there. That would be 47 minus 23, 24. X equal to 12. So we can say that total student in the class are equal to 12. But what, from my point of view, if you are able to understand to form this basic equation, then whatever the complicated question is there, you may solve it very easily, right? Here answer, I can say that total students in the class is said to be 12. 12 becomes my answer, right? Or there is one more standard approach here, means average was 21, right? After adding the teacher 2, average become 23, right? Now age of the teacher is 47, it means what is the difference? 24, 47 minus 23 is 24, right? And that 24 is equally distributed in number of students by 2 years, right? So 24 by 2, I get my 12, hence I can say total students are said to be 12. That may also be approach, right? But sometimes that may be confusing. So you may go by this, answer is said to be 12. Second one is, average weight of a class of 20 students is 45. A new student whose weight is 40 replaces an old student, right? Hence, the average weight of the whole class decreases by 1. What is the weight of the replaced student, right? Just form a small equation. 20 student average is 45. 20 into 45, that's my total sum, right? A new student whose weight is 40 replaces an old, means new student comes with 40 and replaces an old. Let us say the age of the replaced student is X, right? My number of students are the same because one has gone and one has come, right? Hence, the average weight of the whole class decreases by 1. Earlier, my average weight was 45, now it becomes 44. And number of students are 20. I have to find the value of x. That's my question. X will come here, this comes here, right? So I may say 20 is taken as common. So that would be 45 minus 44, right? Plus 40 equal to x. Right? So I can say x equal to 60. It means the student who is replaced, his age is equal to 60. His weight is equal to 60 kg. Hence, I can say C becomes my answer. Weight of the replaced student is 60 kg. That's my answer. Next one is, just read the question carefully. Average of 9 numbers is 11, right? If each of these number 9 is multiplied by 5, then 5 is added to each of the resultant number, new averages, right? We know that when all the numbers are multiplied by a certain number, average also multiplied by that, right? And if a number is added or subtracted, average will also be added or subtracted by that number. The average of 9 number is 11, right? Each of the 9 number is multiplied by 5. It means new average becomes 11 into 5. that is equal to 55, that you can say. And 5 is added to each of the number, it means my average increases by 5 now, so plus 5. So finally I can say new average is equal to 60, hence I can say C becomes my answer, right? So what you understood here, in any question, when a number, all numbers are multiplied by a certain number, all numbers are multiplied by a certain number, the average will also be multiplied by a certain number, right? And if something is added, then average will also be increases by that. But the condition is that it should be added in all the numbers, right? Hence, we can say, answer to my question is C, 60, 60 becomes my answer. Next one is, read the question carefully. What is given? In a village, average age of n people is 42. But after the verification, it was found that age of a person has been considered 20 years less than the actual age. So the new average after the correction increased by 12. Right? The value of n is. Right? Let us try to solve. Average age of n people is 42. Total age is 42n. That you can say. After verification, it was found that age of a person has been considered 20 year less. Right? It means, suppose age of the person was x, that we have already considered. That was 20 years less than the actual. It means actual must be x plus 20, right? It means that have to be subtracted. And new has to be added, x plus 20, right? So the new average after the correction increased by 12, right? It means I may say that is equal to 54n, because number of persons are n and that is equal to 54, right? Now on that basis, I have to find what is the value of n. Here my question is, on that basis, I have to find out what is the value of n, right? I hope there is some mistake here, because it should be 1.2. It's not 12, it should be 1.2 only we can think of something. Sorry, it should be 1/2. It should be 1/2. Just make it as 1/2, because there is some mistake in writing here. Just take the question as, new average increases by 1/2, right? So I may say, so I can say that is 42.5n, right? Now, this is cancelled out. That goes there, so I can say 0.5n is equal to 20, right? Or you can say n equal to 40. So I can say answer to my question is D, that is 40 persons are there in the village, so it is said to be 40. Let's have the next problem here. In a get together, there were a certain number of gentlemen and certain number of ladies, right? The average height of gentlemen was 187, whereas average height of ladies was 153. Average height of all the person in the party was 165, and there were 66 gentlemen in the party. How many ladies are there? Now, these type of questions can be solved by average or by allegation. First, I explain it by average, then I solve it by allegation, right? Let us say number of ladies are X. It means the gentleman average age is 187. Average height and number of gentlemen are 66 plus ladies are 153, number of ladies are X divided by 66 plus X and total is equal to 165, right? I have to just solve and find the value of X. That's my question. As per to this, my question is I have to find the value of X, right? You may find, but let us go with allegation mixture. How? Gentlemen 187, ladies 153, average is 165. We may apply allegation, right? Subtract slantly, that should be 12, right? And when I observe here, it should be 22. Or I can say 6:11. You may say that 6:11. Now the gentlemen are 66. It means this is 66. Then ladies must be 121, because when 6 is equal to 66, then 11 must be 121, right? Hence we can say 4th is my answer. Total number of ladies in the party were 121. 4th is my answer. Or when you solve this equation, with this equation also you may find that value of X is equal to 121. The answer is said to be 4th one, right? Next one is, just read the question. Average age of a group of people was calculated as 28. This was 2 years more than the correct average, as there was an error in noting the age of two persons as 32 and 36 instead of 21 and 23. How many persons are there in the group? Right? Means calculated average was 28. Let us say number of persons are X. So I may say this was 28X. Right? Actual must be 26 as per to the question, and why it happened because of the error, because noting of two persons as 32 and 36 instead of 21 and 23 means wrong. I have added, I have to subtract, and actual I have to add 21 plus 23. Right, number of persons are X and actual average must be 26X because that is 2 years more. I have to find the value of X. You may easily take it, just take it as 2X equal to. Right, so here I can say minus 11, here I can say minus 13, so that is 24, right, so x equal to 12. How many persons are there in the group? The answer to your question is fourth one. Number of persons in the group are equal to 12, that becomes your answer. Next is, the average cost of 15 mangoes is 26 per mango, right? And 4 more mangoes with an average cost of rupees 36 per mango are purchased, and 7 mangoes with an average cost of 18 per mango are returned. Find the average cost per mango of all the mangoes. Average cost of 15 mangoes is 26, right? It means my cost is 15 into 26 of 15 mangoes. 4 more mangoes with an average cost of 36 means 4 into 36. And 7 mangoes with an average cost of 18 has been returned, minus 7 into 18. Now my number of mangoes are 15 plus 4, 19, and 7 has been returned. So divide by 12, number of mangoes are 12. Right, I have to answer my question. That's my problem now. Right, I have to find this average. So what I can say, just cancel out. I may cancel here 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 12, and 3, 6. That right, I may cancel 2 now. 2, 13, 2, 6, 2, 3. So I'm being left with 13, 5 is 65 plus 24 minus 21 upon 2, right? So this is 65 plus 3, 68 by 2. So I can say that is 34, right? So I can say that average cost per mango of all the mangoes is equal to rupees 34. Second becomes my answer. Now, in this type of question, sometime first we multiply all them and then subtract, but it's better if you go by direct a division. That would be very helpful to you. Hence we can say average cost is 34. Right, let's have the next problem here. In an examination conducted among, just read the question. In an examination conducted among 13 students, the average of their score was 60. Top 7, 66, and least 7 is 54. What is the 7th highest, right? So I may say that top 7, 66, it means top 7 is 7 into 66, right? Least 7, 7 into 54, but total students are 13. It means I can say that that 7th student has been included twice, here as well as here. If I subtract 13th from here, so I am being left with the age of the 7th highest scorer, right? Just solve it. What you can say, you have to answer it, right? I may say that 6 would be taken as common, right? That is 7 into 11, 7 into 9, minus 13 into 10, right? That is 77 plus 63, minus 130, okay? 3701, 140, minus 130 into 6, so 6 into 10, 60, right? So I can say that the 7th highest score, 64th is my answer. That's my answer, right? Next one is, average marks of class are 65%, average score of 12 student who failed is 35%, and if the student who are excluded, the average marks of the class would increase by 15 percent point. Find the strength of the class, right? What I can say that if I have to find the strength of the class, so let us say strength of the class is X and the marks and total marks are 100. Strength of the class is X and maximum marks are 100. Average marks of class are 65%. Whole class average marks is 65%. It means the whole class mark is 65x, that you can say. Right, the average score of 12 students who failed is 35. Right, 12 who failed is 35. It means you may say 12 into 35. Right, if these students are excluded, just subtract from here. If these are excluded from here, right, the average would increase by 15 percent point. It means my student would be x minus 12 now, and average would increase by 15 percent point. It means 35 plus 15, that is 50. Right? I have to find the strength of the whole class. Just observe it. That is, let us say student are x and average is 65%. It means total is 65x. One thing I can say, then it is given that 12 students who failed, their average is 35. Means if that is subtracted from here, that is subtracted from here, so I am being left with for those students who are not failed. So that strength is x minus 12, and the class average would increase by 15 percent point, that is in 65. So it should be 80. 65 plus 15, that is 80. I have to find the value of x. So what I can say, 65x minus 12, 5, 60, 0, 6, 36 and 6, 42 equal to 80x minus 960, right? That goes there and that comes here, right? So 960 minus 420, that is said to be 540, equal to 80x minus 16x, 15x. So x is equal to 540 by 15, 15, 3, 45 and 6, 36, right? So we can say that strength of the class is equal to 36. First is my answer, 36 is becomes my. The next question is, number of students attending class from Monday to Saturday in a particular week were consecutive integers in increasing order, right? It means I can say x, x plus 1, x plus 2 up to Saturday, so that is x plus 5, right? Then average number of students attending the class from Monday to Thursday was 33.5, right? Average number of students attending the class. It means I may say Monday to Thursday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday. It means x plus 1, x plus 2 plus x plus 3 divided by 4, that is 33.5, right? So you may say 4x plus 6 equal to multiply by 4, 4, 5, 20, 0, carry 2, 4, 3, 12, 2, 14, 4, carry 1, 12 or 1, 13, right? So 4x equal to 140. So I can say x equal to 4, 3, 12, 35, that you can get, right? Now the next point is average daily attendance in the class from Tuesday to Saturday. When I say Tuesday to Saturday, means Tuesday to Saturday, add all. So that would be 5x plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5, that is 15. Right? I have to take the average divided by 5. It is x plus 3. So it should be 35 plus 3. It should be 38. Right? You can say that because when I divide it, 35 plus 3, that is 38. Here I can say that from Tuesday to Saturday, average is 38, answer must be 38. There may be some problem here because he's asking from Tuesday to Saturday. So 5 days are there, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. So I have to just solve by this, the answer must be 38, right? Next one is, just read the question. Average weight of student in a class is 62. Two student was weight 43 and 45 leave the class. The average weight of the class increases by 2 years. How many students were there in the class initially? Let us say students are equal to x, right? The total student are 62. It should be 62x. Two student leave the class, minus 43 minus 45. Average weight of the class increases by 2. It means now my total students are equal to x minus 2. And weight of the class increases by 2. It means it has become equal to 64. I have to find the value of x. So I may say 62x minus 538 and 448 equal to 64x minus 128. Right? This is 2x equal to 128 minus 88, that is 40. X equal to 20. Right? Here I can say that initial students of the class are equal to 20. Third becomes my answer. Next one is, 30 liter of 20% milk is mixed with 20 liter of 25% milk, we have to find the concentration in the resulting solution, right? So 30 liter of 20% milk means 6 liter milk, right? Total is 30. Second is 20 liter of 25% milk, 5 liter milk, total is 20. Total milk is 11 and total solution is 50 into 100, right? Just solve it, you may say 22%, hence I can say second is my answer, right? The concentration of the milk in the resulting solution is 22%. Next question is, average rainfall in the month of January to February is 6, March to June is 5, and July to October is 10, November to December is 6. Average rainfall for the whole year, right? Basic question, January and February is 6, means total is 2 into 6, plus March, April, May, June, 4 month, 4 into 5, plus July, August, September, October, 4 month, 4 into 10, November and December, 2 into 6, divide by 12, right? 12 plus 20 plus 40 plus 12 upon 12, right? 60 plus 24, 84 by 12, so that is said to be 7. The average rainfall for the whole year is 7, hence I can say A becomes my answer. Next one is, fresh grapes contains 85% water, whereas dried grapes contain 20% water. How many kg of dried grapes can be obtained from 64 kg of fresh grapes, right? So let us say total fresh grapes and dried grapes. Water and content of grape, 85% water means 15% content of grape, right? 20% water, 80% content of grape, right? We have 64 kg of fresh grapes. It means content of grape is 15%. The 15 for the 60, 0, carry 6, 90 and 6, 96. So I can say 9.6 kg. Means from 64 kg, the grapes is 9.6 kg, right? This 9.6 is now equal to 80%. Because that's the content of grape. In the dried grapes, only water will change. Content of the grape will remain the same. So I can say that 80% of the dried grapes is equal to 9.6. So 100% is equal to 9.6 by 80 into 100. So I may say 12 kg. Hence we can say that second is my answer. So total grapes, dried grapes are equal to 12 kg out of 64 kg of fresh grapes. Right. Next one is, in 2008, Ravi spent 5,000 per month on an average for first 4 months, 6,500 average of 5 months, and 4,500 for 3 months. His savings were 18,000 in the year. Find the average monthly income, right? So 5,000 per month for 4 months, total is 20,000. 65 for next 5 months, multiply by 5, 0, 0, 25, 5, 2, 30 or 2, 32, right? And 45 per month for last 3 months, right? Multiply by 3, 13500, 459312, total income is 00, 55100, carry 1, 426, 23516, right? His savings are 18,000, it means total income must be 84,000, right? And I have to find the monthly income average, divide by 12, that is 7,000, right? Here we can say that, 4th is my answer, average monthly income is 7,000, 4th is my answer. 2 kinds of wheat costing 17 per kg and 24 per kg are mixed in 4:3. We have to find cost of the mixture, right? Let us say first one is 4 and second one is 3. You may say 17 into 4 plus 24 into 3 divide by 4 plus 3, right? 68, 72 by 7, that is 140 by 7. Average is 20, right? So I can say that third is my answer. Cost of mixture is 20. Third becomes your answer. Average score of 40 students in a mathematics test is 50. Highest and lowest were excluded. Average of the class decreased by 1, right? And difference between them is 60. We have to find the highest and lowest, right? Average is 40. 40 into 50, right? subtract, let us say, A and B, highest and lowest. Now, total are 38 and average decreases by 1. It means average becomes 49. Right? So, from here I can find out A plus B. So, here you can say that A plus B equal to 40 into 50, right? That is 2000 minus 38 into 49. That you have to solve it. Right, 9 and 72, 7, 27 and 7, 34, right, 4 and 32, 2, 3, 12 and 3, 15, 2, 6, 8 and 1, right, so I may say 1, 8, 6, 2. Here you can say A plus B equal to 138 and the difference is 60, A minus B is given, that is equal to 60, add both, 2A is equal to 8, 9 and 1, right, A equal to 99. So, here question is, we have to find the highest scorer. So I can say third is my answer, highest scorer is 99. Right, next is average marks scored by 120 student is 35. Average marks of the student who passed is 39, failed is 15. The number of student who passed. So let us say student who passed is equal to x and failed is 120 minus x. Right, so x is passed, x into 39 plus 120 minus x into 15. Equal to 120 into 35, right? From here you can easily find the value of x. So that is the number of students who passed. The similar question may also be solved with allegation mixture. Average weight of 11 players of Indian cricket team is increased by 1 when one player of team weighting 55 is replaced by another player. The weight of the new player is, right? First of all, I observe that, let us say, average is x, let us say that average is x, right, and new player is y, okay. So 11 player, average is x, 11x, when one player replace 55 kg replaced by a new player, so minus 55 plus y, right, average increases by 1, it means it becomes 12x, right. It means I can say that it becomes 12x as per the question. 11 player, average weight of 11 player when replaced, it should be 11. It should be 11, right? The average weight of 11 players, players are 11, right? It should be x plus 1. That's my point here, right? Because average weight was x, now it is x plus 1. Now solve it. 11x minus 55 plus y. 11x plus 11. This is cancelled out. So I may say y equal to 66, right? So new player that has been changed is equal to 66 kg. C becomes your answer. So this is end to our first practice session of the concept of average. I hope you enjoyed the session. You may send your feedback to me at my email ID legalbuddy@gmail.com or you may connect me on my Facebook @DineshMiglani Tutorials. For any query, you may WhatsApp at my number 092-155-14-34-35. Thank you very much.